Hello and welcome back to Unacademy platform. So let's crack me PG. Myself Dr. Muskan Chaudhary and I will be your mentor for microbiology. So before starting today's topic, it is Klebsiella and Proteus. Let me acknowledge you with the Unacademy platform. As we know that the Unacademy is India's largest learning platform and it provides a daily live class, daily quizzes, and within the live classes, the educator and the student can interact, can ask the queries, can ask the doubts that too within the live class and can take participate in the live polling for question answers, and this will help the student to evaluate the preparation, how much is lagging behind. Now also one more advantage is that the student can keep the recorded videos and can whatever whenever he feel like in the OPD, day shift, night shift, and for the doctors who are working at the periphery and who are doing the JR shift. Now also the Unacademy provides the structured courses for the complete 19 subjects, and as we know that to cover the whole 19 subjects within a short period of time, something that is needed to crack any competitive exam, and on this Unacademy platform, it is provided by the topmost educators. Now I will recommend you to have at least 1 to 2 year subscription, especially 1 year subscription for those who are the droppers and who are the post interns or the interns, and for the students who are working or doing the JR ship and having kids and are the shortage of the time, I will recommend them to have at least 2 year subscription to have at least a backup plan for the next year in case they do not get the desired rank result this year. So please do use my code, that is Muskan. Now starting with the Klebsiella, as we know, just a second. Klebsiella belong to Enterobacteriaceae family. Okay, now Klebsiella is gram negative bacilli belonging to Enterobacteriaceae family, and Enterobacteriaceae family are Peritrichus family. Apart from the SACI that are immotile, so who are the SACI members of the Enterobacteriaceae family? Isme aa gaya Shigella, Salmonella, atypical E. coli and Yersinia, and Salmonella is motile but Salmonella gallinarum is immotile. And Enterobacteriaceae family by the Peritrichus flagella, that means the flagella is present all around the surface apart from the SACI that is immotile. Now Klebsiella, the other name for the Klebsiella is Phelandens bacilli. They are non-motile and the lactose fermenters. Remember those lactose and non-lactose by non-lactose fermenters are SHIPs. Now Shigella, Yersinia, Proteus and Salmonella. Now they are urease positive and the catalase positive. All the Enterobacteriaceae family are the catalase positive except the Shigella dysentery type 1 that are catalase negative. Also now the basic point of Klebsiella kya ho, ek to Phelandens bacilli hote non motile hote hain, lactose fermenters hote hain, non motile non lactose fermenters can be remained by the mnemonic SHIPs, and they are urease positive and the catalase positive. Now moving next, they are capsulated. Klebsiella are capsulated. To remember the organism who are capsulated, Yersinia bacteria have killer and the mean capsule. So why say Yersinia, Streptococcus pneumonia, Bacterial strigilis, H influenza, Klebsiella, Anthrax bacillus, Neisseria meningitis, Clostridium perfringens, also Pseudomonas. Now Bordetella pertussis have non antigenic capsule. Capsule is वैसे capsule antigenic nature का होता है. It produce inflammatory response and therefore since it is antigenic तो specific antibodies डालते हैं तो quelling reaction show करता है. But Bordetella pertussis में क्या होता है, non antigenic capsule होता है. इसके अलावा जो bacterial flagellus होता है, Zwitter ionic capsule होता है, जबकि capsule mostly no net charge present होता है. That is no charge is usually present. So remember कि कौन कौन से important capsulated bacteria हैं, Yersinia bacteria killer and mean capsule, Yersinia, Streptococcus pneumonia, Bacterial strigilis, H influenza, Klebsiella, Anthrax bacillus, Neisseria, Clostridium perfringens. नाउ हाउ टू रिमेम्बर कौन कौन से यूरियस पॉजिटिव है, एज आई टोल्ड यू की तो क्लैप्सिला यूरियस और कैटलेज दोनों पॉजिटिव हैं. एंटीरोबैक्टीरिया से एंटायर फैमिली इज कैटलेज पॉजिटिव एक्सेप्ट फॉर द शिगेला डिजेंट्री टाइप 1. नाउ कैन रिमेम्बर्ड बाय द निमोनिक पंच किस प्रोटीस यूरियोप्लाज्म नोकार्डिया क्रिप्टोकोकस एच फॉर हेलिकोबैक्टर के फॉर क्लैप्सिला सेप्रोफाइटिकस एंड एपिडिडर्म. ओके नाउ ओके नाउ क्या होता है कि जो क्लैप्सिला होता है क्लैप्सिला सिंस इज क्लैप्सिला इज कैप्सुलेटेड दैट इज थिक कैप्सूल इज प्रेजेंट देयरफॉर ड्यू टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ थिक कैप्सूल इट गिव्स म्यूकॉइड कॉलोनीज मैकॉन्की अगार पे भी और ब्लड अगार पे भी. तो दिस इज मैकॉन्की अगार एंड सिंस इट इज लैक्टोज फर्मेंटर सो ऑन मैकॉन्की अगार इट प्रोड्यूस लार्ज डोम शेप्ड म्यूकॉइड ड्यू टू थिक कैप्सूल दैट इज स्टिकी इन नेचर पिंक कलर लैक्टोज फॉर्मेटिंग कॉलोनीज ऑन द ब्लड अगार स्लाइमी अपियरेंस ऑफ द कॉलोनीज सो ऑन द ब्लड अगार ऑल्सो दे गिव्स म्यूकॉइड कॉलोनीज दैट इज ड्यू टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ द थिक कैप्सूल. नाउ स्ट्रिंग टेस्ट. स्ट्रिंग टेस्ट इज गिवन बाई टू ऑर्गेनिज्म एक तो क्लैप्सिला और दूसरा विब्रो. नाउ अ कॉलोनी दैट स्ट्रेचेज अप टू 5 mm यूजिंग अ स्टैंडर्ड इनोकुलेशन लूप टेस्ट पॉजिटिव फॉर द हाइपर म्यूकोविस्कोसिटी म्यूकॉइड कॉलोनी ऑफ क्लैप्सिला निमोनी वैन कॉलोनीज वर टेस्ट विद द लूप एंड द लूप लिफ्टेड वर्टिकली फ्रॉम द सर्फेस ऑफ द कार प्लेट म्यूकॉइड आइसोलेट्स एडेड टू द लूप एज इट वॉज लिफ्टेड फ्रॉम द प्लेट. सो स्ट्रिंग टेस्ट गिवन बाय द क्लैप्सिला एंड विब्रो. Now, Klebsiella pneumoniae is urease positive, catalase positive, and it causes pneumonia mainly upper lower. Hota kya hai ki Klebsiella ki growth favor karti hai aerobic environment. So therefore, upper lobe mein zyada oxygen concentration ki wajah se the growth of the bacteria is more in the upper lobe, in the upper respiratory tract. Along with this, UTI Klebsiella is the third most main reason for the UTI abdominal and wound surgical site infection. It is one of the main reason for the acquired infection, hospital acquired nosocomial infection. Iske alawa UTI, cystitis, prostatitis, ye sab bhi Klebsiella cause karta hai. Now Klebsiella oizina, it cause oizina that is foul smelling nasal discharge or the atrophic rhinitis. Question is asked, oizina cause foul smelling nasal discharge or atrophic rhinitis. Now Klebsiella rhinoscleromatis cause the rhinoscleroma or woody nose jo ki chronic granulomatous hypertrophic nose hoti hai. Now this is showing the rhinoscleroma woody nose and biopsy pe humko two specific cells are present in the rhinoscleromatis. One is the Mikulic cells and another is Russell bodies. Now Mikulic cells ke the large foam cells are present. If you can appreciate this, large foam cells are present with central nucleus and vacuolated cytoplasm. And Russell body, they are eosinophilic inclusion bodies. This darkly stained cells are the Russell bodies. This is Russell body and this is foam cell with large vacuolated cytoplasm. These are the large foam cells with the central nucleus and vacuolated cytoplasm containing causative bacilli and Russell body. These are the homogeneous eosinophilic inclusion bodies found in the plasma. They occur due to accumulation of the immunoglobulins. Now Klebsiella pneumoniae, that is same, that is showing the mucoid colonies on the Mekonki agar due to presence of the thick capsule. This red current jelly sputum due to pneumonia caused by the Klebsiella upper lobe. Now coming to the next Serratia sif, ek a point important is Serratia ke that it produces the characteristic property of the Serratia is the production of the non-diffusible pigment that is prodigiosin. And serratia produces non-diffusible pigment, and diffusible pigment are produced by the Staphylococcus aureus or Pseudomonas. So the characteristic property of the serratia is the production of the non-diffusible pigment called prodigiosin. Diffusible pigment is produced by the Staphylococcus aureus or Pseudomonas. Now, coming to the protease, protease is motile and non-lactose fermenters, as we know by ships. Okay, it is motile, non-lactose fermented. Tribe characteristics, it is gives PPA test positive. Phenylalanine D-aminase test, this PPA test is positive by the protease species. Now, both the Proteus mirabilis and vulgaris are urease positive, can be remembered by the mnemonic, which we discussed, can be punch kiss, and H2S positive test. Indole test is positive by the vulgaris and negative for the mirabilis. Now, it shows the pleomorphism, that is different characteristic shapes. Now, since it is gram negative, appears in the various forms, coccobacilli, bacillary, or in the filamentous form, therefore it is pleomorphism. Characteristic is shown. Order, it is mainly fishy and seminal order in culture. It shows the swarming pattern on the solid media's ability to spread. Organism which swarms are the Proteus, Clostridium titani, Parahemolyticus and Serratia. Now, one important characteristic feature, that is Dines phenomenon, shows it is done to differentiate the between the different strains of the Proteus family. A Proteus, also one more thing, we'll see the Dines in the next slide. Proteus form the struvite stone since it is urease positive. So, kya karte hai ki urea ko todta hai ammonia mein. Now, ammonia causes the urine to be alkaline nature and it causes the deposition of the phosphate, causing the result of phosphate stones. Also, Klebsiella also causes the deposition of the phosphate stones. So, it causes the struvite stones in the bladder in alkaline urine. Ammonia causing alkaline urine and deposition of the phosphate causing stones. The non-motile strains of the Proteus are basis of the Weil-Fallick test. OX19, OX2, that is used for the Weil-Fallick test. OXK. 9, that is 19, 2 and K are used in the Weil-Fallick reaction. Now, protease motile hoga, PPA test positive, that is important, and it is urease and H2S positive. Indole test is positive for P. vulgaris and negative for mirabilis. Now, it shows pleomorphism, fishy or seminal order hota culture mein, and it shows a swarming pattern, that is the ability to spread in the solid medium, and it shows the Dines phenomena. It is done to differentiate between the different strains of the same family for the Proteus, and Proteus causes the deposition of the phosphate causing the result of the struvite stones in the bladder in the alkaline urine. Alkaline urea is caused by the urease enzyme which break down the urea into ammonia and causing the urine to be alkaline. Now, and 19-2 and OXK form the basis of Weil-Fallick test. This is swarming pattern shown by the Proteus. Swarming effect over the blood agar as a consequences of the organism active motility. Now, this is PPA test positive in the Proteus. Now, PPA test mein kya hota hai ki agar phenylalanine D-aminase is present, gives the green color. The reaction to know the reaction is not important. PPA test positive kisme yaad rakhna hai. Now, it is a Dine phenomena and it is line of the differentiation is present between the two different strains of the protease. So, it is shown that the strain separation by a narrow visible furrow, narrow visible line, that means the two different strains are present of protease. Agar ek hi strain present to the, it would have fused. The both the lines would have fused together. So, it is Dines phenomena shown by the Proteus. Now, when two strain When two strains of the protease are inoculated on two different areas of culture plate, a swarming of the two strains merge incompletely, remain separated by the line of the demarcation. Two strains are different. A swarming of the two strains merge, then without a line of demarcation, that means the two strains are identical. Now, struvite stones, just like a protease produces the struvite stones with deposition of the phosphate causing the due to alkaline urine produced by the enzyme urease, composed of the magnesium ammonium phosphate crystals. Infection stones or the triple phosphate stones, Stegon calculi are typical struvite stones caused by the infection by the urease positive bacteria, that is protease. It causes the increase in the alkali pH of the urine and allows the crystals to form due to deposition of the phosphate. Now the Dines phenomena is seen with both protease mirabilis and protease vulgaris. Okay, two different strains ho gaye, and it will show the Dines phenomena. Okay, now revising the topic before doing the question answers for Streptococcus that we left yesterday. Now, Klebsiella belong to the Enterobacteriaceae family, and Enterobacteriaceae family is gram-negative bacilli motile by the peritrichus. Now, Klebsiella is feed Landon's bacilli. They are non-motile and the lactose fermenters. Capsulated produce mucoid colonies and are what? Urease positive and catalase positive. And all Enterobacteriaceae family are catalase positive except for Shigella dysentery type 1. Now, important capsulated bacteria is Yersinia and vector killer mean capsule can be remembered by this. Yersinia, Streptococcus pneumonia, Bacteroides fragilis, H. influenza, Klebsiella, Anthrax bacillus, Neisseria meningitis, Clostridium perfringens. Also, one more thing to remember, capsule is antigenic in nature, lekin Bordetella pertussis is non-antigenic capsule. Also, capsule is do not have any no net charge, so bacteroid fragilis shows Zwitter ion. Now, urease positive organism can be remembered by the mnemonic, that is Punchkiss. Now, Punchkiss, protease, Uroplasmonocardia, Cryptococcus, Helicobacter, Klebsiella, Saprophyticus and Epididermis. Now, coming to the on the Meconkey agar, Meconkey agar pe mucoid colony present hai due to presence of the thick capsule. This is blood agar showing the dome shape due to thick capsule, mucoid colonies. Now, string test is positive both by the Klebsiella and the protease. And Klebsiella pneumonia is urease positive and it causes pneumonia, upper lobe UTI infection, wound and surgical site infection. One is Klebsiella oestrogena and Klebsiella rhinosclerosis cause the woody nose appearance. Now, these are the two important histological features. One is mucolytic cells. What are mucolytic cells? What are large vacuolated cells. So, this is organism present. What are Klebsiella? And one is the Russell body. A Russell body is the eosinophilic inclusion bodies. So, you can see this is Russell body and mucolytic cell. Also, the Klebsiella is one of the reason for the hospital acquired nosocomial infections like urinary catheters, causing cystitis. Pyelonephritis or prostatitis and causing lobar pneumonia, later causing the lung abscess. And through central venous catheter, they may cause bacteremia. Now for the diagnosis of the Klebsiella, it can be one by alkaline pH of the urine. By alkaline क्योंकि urease produce हो रहा है तो urease, urea को तोड़ के ammonia causing the raise of pH of urine. One is the alkalinity of the urine. दूसरा if lobar pneumonia is caused, then it will cause the cavitary lesions. Other than this, meconium agar, blood agar and string test. Now coming to serratia, it causes the presence of the non-diffusible pigment. It produces a non-diffusible pigment, that is protogeosin, and diffusible pigment are produced by the Staphylococcus aureus and Pseudomonas. Now coming to the protease motile होते हैं, non-lactose fermenters होते हैं, that is non-lactose can be remembered by the mnemonic SHIPS. PPA test is positive and both protease mirabilis and vulgaris are H2N urease positive. Indol test is positive for the P. vulgaris. It shows the pleomorphism and shows the fishy or the seminal order in culture. Now swarming pattern present होता है protease में, Dines phenomena is present, that is used to differentiate the two related strains of the protease family. And the non-motile strains, that is OX19-2 and OXK, they are used for the Weil-Felix reaction. Now blood agar, it shows the protease, shows the swarming pattern. PPA test is positive in the protease. Now Dines phenomena, this is narrow line showing the two different strains of protease. Now when two strains of the proteins are included in two different area, two strains merge incompletely, then two strains are different, and if the two strains merge completely, then means that belongs to the same identical strains. Now coming to the question of the Streptococcus with the topic we discussed yesterday. Now Lenzfield grouping of the Streptococcus is done on the basis of the group C carbohydrate antigen, as we know ki alpha, beta or gamma, hemolysis on the basis of hemolysis on the horse blood agar. Alpha means Streptococcus viridans and Streptococcus pneumoniae. Beta mein A to V except I and J. Group A belong to Streptococcus pyogenes and group B belong to Streptococcus agalactiae. And beta ko further divide kiya tha on the basis serotyping A to V by the Lenzfields on the basis of the carbohydrate C antigen. And gamma shows colorless, no hemolysis. Okay, now Lenzfield grouping is done. Streptococcus toxin which is responsible for the connective tissue breakdown is hyaluronidase, extracellular enzyme produced by the streptococcus. Now streptolysin O and S, they cause the lysis of the RBC membrane, and the pyrogenic toxin causes the scarlet fever, necrotizing fasciitis and toxic shock syndrome by streptococcus. So streptococcal toxic shock syndrome. Also on the basis of this toxin, Dick test is done. Dick test mein kya hota hai ki intradermal injection de dete hain toxin ka, and it will produce erythema in those children who are susceptible to develop the scarlet fever. Now false regarding Streptococcus pyogenes. Streptococcus pyogenes cause necrotizing fasciitis, that is true due to presence of the streptococcal erythrogenic toxin. बीटा हेमोलिटिक स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस अल्फा बीटा एंड गामा बीटा स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजेंस ग्रुप ए बिलोंग टू बीटा हेमोलिसिस एम प्रोटीन इज वायलेंस फैक्टर येस बिकॉज स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस पायोजेंस को फर्दर सीरोटाइप ग्रिफिथ ने सीरोटाइपिंग बेस्ड ऑन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द एम टी आर प्रोटीन्स एंड एम जीनोटाइपिंग वॉज डन ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ प्रेजेंस ऑफ एम जीन. Resistance to bacitracin. Streptococcus group A and B, beta hemolytic streptococcus a pyogens and agalicti. Pyogens is bacitracin sensitive and PYR test positive. Jabki streptococcus agalicti is bacitracin resistant and PYR test is negative, but CAM test is positive. Hydrolysis test is positive and gives all orange colored pigment production enhanced in Islam's media. So option D is correct. Which streptococcal antigen cross reacts with synovial fluid? Now with synovial fluid, capsular hyaluronic acid reacts. Peptidoglycan react with the skin antigens. Cell wall proteins and protein react with myocardium, NCM react with myocardium. So answer here will be capsular. And carbohydrate group A react with the cardiac valves. A child present with sepsis bacteria is isolated showing beta hemolysis on the blood agar. Is beta hemolysis resistant to bacitracin and positive for CAM test. As I told you कि एक तो streptococcus pyogens and agalicti में main difference यही है कि pyogens is bacitracin sensitive, it is resistant. Also it is PYR test positive, it is absent and but it shows CAM test, hydrolysis test and Islam's media mein enhanced pigment production orange. So streptococcus agalicti will be the right answer. Neonatal meningitis acquired during passage through the birth canal is due to. Now neonatal meningitis are of two types, ek to hota early onset aur dusra hota late onset. Early onset matlab within after birth, so it is mainly caused due to transfer from the मदर्स वजाइनल फ्लूइड से और लेट मतलब आफ्टर 8 to 10 डेज ऑफ डिलीवरी. सो इट इज मेनली कॉज्ड बाय द स्प्रेड फ्रॉम द कम्युनिटी एंड नियोनेटल मैनिंजाइटिस द मेन मोस्ट कॉमन कॉज इज द स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस एगेलेक्टी. इन अदर ऑल एज ग्रुप्स द कॉमन कॉज इज द स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस pneumonia, but in the neonates the main cause is streptococcus agalicti. So this will be the answer. Treatment of the streptococcus necrotizing fasciitis. Now treatment of the streptococcus, first thing is the streptococcus fasciitis or necrotizing fasciitis or scarlet fever or streptococcal toxic shock syndrome are caused by the streptococcal pyrogenic exotoxin. And jo treatment hai uska ek to yoga penicillin, clindamycin and surgical debridement also. So P and C. A patient is present with the cough with rusty sputum on examination, lower lobe consolidation, bronchial breath sound. It gives the positive Killing test. Now, as I told you that streptococcus puri to capsulated nahi hoti, but A, B, C, D group of beta hemolysis. Beta hemolytic streptococcus shows the capsule along with the streptococcus pneumoniae. So, it shows the one is the quelling reaction. And lower lobe consolidation with rusty sputum. So as we know, streptococcus pneumonia causes the lobar pneumonia and is also capsulated, and it is gram positive cocci. So will be B. Most common organism causing acute otitis media. Now streptococcus pneumonia cause MOPS. What is MOPS? एक तो meningitis हो गया सारे age group में, लेकिन neonatal meningitis is caused by the streptococcus agalacti. And otitis media, pneumonia, and as for sinusitis. Now in the children, the acute otitis media is caused by the streptococcus pneumonia. Most common organism cause acute otitis media, and that is same question. C in C reactive protein stands for the carbohydrate antigen, जिसके basis पे Lansfield ने grouping की थी. In a splenectomized patient, there is increased risk of in splenectomy, there is increased infection by the एक तो H influenza, एक Neisseria meningitis and Streptococcus pneumococci. Also one thing more कि as I told you कि encapsulated bacteria is remembered by the mnemonic, ऐसे bacteria mean capsule. Now pneumococci is capsulated, H influenza is capsulated, capsula is capsulated. Now when the organism is capsulated, it has increased risk of pathogenesis and virulence, क्योंकि capsulated is antigenic and itself acts as a protective barrier. So in a splenectomized patient, and also the spleen remove the capsule of the organism and decrease the virulence of the organism. तो ये सब तो कैप्सुलेटेड हैं, एंड सिंस द स्प्लीन इज नॉट देयर, सो द वायलेंस ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनिज्म विल इंक्रीज कंपेयर टू स्टेफ ओरियस. सो एक्सेप्शन पूछा है तो स्टेफ ओरियस. एंड द जो ये तीन बेसिक ऑर्गेनिज्म है, एच इन्फ्लुएंजा, नाइजीरिया मेनिनजाइटिस, स्टेफाइल दिस स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस निमोकाई, देयर इज वेरी इंक्रीज इन्फेक्शन फॉर द स्प्लेनेक्टमी पेशेंट हु हैज गॉन अंडरगॉन द स्प्लेनेक्टमी. Most common causative organisms for the lobar pneumonia. Lobar pneumonia, as I told you, ki MOPS is caused by the streptococcus pneumococci. That is meningitis in the all the age group except neonatal, that is caused by the streptococcus agalacti. Otitis media and pneumonia and sinusitis and streptococcus pneumonia causes the lobar pneumonia, most common cause of the most common organism causing acute otitis media, as I told you, streptococcus pneumonia. Okay, now also we'll discuss today the scientist So first we'll discuss the Anton Philipp van Leeuwen handbook. So Anton van Leeuwen handbook, he was the first who observed the bacteria and the microorganism using a single lens microscope. So it can be remembered ki Anton ne small animal dekhe. Small animal means microorganisms under the microscope. So he was the first to see the small animals or the microorganism under the microscope. He observed the bacteria and microorganism under the microscope. Now talking about the Edward Jenner. Now Edward Jenner developed the first vaccine in the smallpox, that is a smallpox vaccine. Now, how to remember that is Edward is स्मॉल मतलब स्मॉल पॉक्स वैक्सीन दी थी उसने. दैट इज़ द फर्स्ट वैक्सीन वॉज डेवलप्ड बाय द एडवर्ड जेनर एंड ही यूज द काउपॉक्स वायरस टू इम्यूनाइज द चिल्ड्रन अगेंस्ट द स्मॉल पॉक्स एंड कॉइन द टर्म फ्रॉम वेयर द वैक्सीन टर्म हैज़ बीन डेराइव्ड. सो एडवर्ड इज स्मॉल मतलब एडवर्ड ने स्मॉल पॉक्स फर्स्ट वैक्सीनेशन दैट इज स्मॉल पॉक्स वैक्सीन दी थी. Now coming to the Louis Pasteur. Now Louis Pasteur is the father of the microbiology. He had proposed principles for the fermentation and he has introduced the sterilization technique. This can be remembered ki S is sterilization technique di thi and T say theory of spontaneous generation disapproved ki thi. And one is the he as we all know from school time ki he gave the pasteurizer, he described the method of pasteurization of the milk. He also contributed to the vaccine development against several diseases, that is anthrax, cholera and rabies. So he gave sterilization technique, theory of spontaneous ko reject kiya tha, rabies, anthrax and cholera iske against vaccination di. And he disapproved the theory of spontaneous generation of disease and postulated the germ theory of disease. He stated the disease cannot be caused by the bat, air or vaporizer, but it is produced by the organism present in it. And one more thing, he gave the liquid media concept. So what are given by the father of micrologic, the fermentation technique, sterilization technique, pasteurization of the milk, and gave the rabies, anthrax and cholera, and a theory of spontaneous generation was rejected and he gave the germ theory. Okay, now Joseph Lister can be remembered, he gave the he is the father of the antiseptic surgery. Now coming to the Robert Koch. Now Robert Koch introduced solid media. Solid media for the culture of the bacteria. Also he gave the Koch phenomena. Now Robert Koch observed that the guinea pigs that who are already infected with the tubercular bacilli, they developed the hypersensitive reaction. That the guinea pig who were already infected with the tubercular bacilli, they developed a hypersensitive reaction when they were injected with tubercular bacilli or its protein. So this observation is known as the Koch phenomena. Now what is Koch postulate? Robert Koch has postulated that a microorganism can be accepted as the causative organism for any infectious disease only jab uske char criteria fulfill honge. One is that ki that microorganism is constantly so matlab ki wo microorganism wahi disease ko particular disease ko cause karega and jis bhi organism ko disease ho, it is possible to isolate that organism from the isolate the bacteria from the same organism and us organism us bacteria ko utha ke us jo host tha usse utha ke dusre host mein dala then it will cause the same disease when jab humne usko isolate karke dusre ko infect kiya. So this organism microorganism should be constantly be associated with the lesion of the disease and it should be possible to isolate the organism in the pure culture from the lesion of the disease and the same disease must result when the isolated microorganism is inoculated in suitable laboratory animal and it should be possible to again re-isolate the organism. So it should cause the constantly be associated with the disease when it is isolated and inoculated in the laboratory animal, it will cause the same disease and it is possible to re-isolate the organism bacteria in from the experimental animals. Now, what are the exceptions of the Koch postulates? Now, one is this, he gave Koch phenomena and the Koch postulate. Koch phenomena that he observed, the guinea pig who are once infected with the tubercular bacilli will result in the hypersensitive reaction when they are again infected with the tubercular bacilli. Now, Koch postulate is said that the microorganism that is constantly associated with the organism to cause the same disease, and it is possible to re-isolate the organism from the host that present with the same disease, and it is possible to inoculate the isolated bacteria into the laboratory animals and to re-isolate the same bacteria from the laboratory animals, and it will cause the same disease. Now, what are the exceptions? Ecto mycobacterium, Lepra and Treponema pallidum, they cannot be grown in the in vitro, however can be maintained in the experimental animals. And the another is the Neisseria gonorrhea. Now, Mycobacterium lepra, Treponema pallidum and Neisseria gonorrhea. Neisseria gonorrhea have no animal mode, but they can be grown in vitro. Now, Paul Ehrlich gave the, he is the father of chemotherapy. That is, can be remembered by the Paul L. Rick is the father of chemotherapy. He proposed the side chain theory for the antibody. Of how to remember this, ki Paul Ehrlich, CH4 gave, father of chemotherapy, and CH is present in the कॉर्नर मोस्ट सबसे आखिरी में साइड में है, तो ये के साइड चेन थ्योरी. ओके, नाउ रिवाइजिंग द टॉपिक. नाउ एंटनी कैन बी रिमेंबर दैट ही गेव द स्मॉल एनिमल्स. Small animals mean first observed the bacteria and the microorganism under the single lens microscope that was constructed by him. So Antony Philip gave A for animals, small animal, that is microorganisms. Now Edward Jenner, that can be, okay, Edward is small, so he gave the first vaccine, that is smallpox. And the term the vaccine has been derived. He used the cowpox virus to immunize the children against the smallpox. Now the Louis Pasteur is the father of the microbiology, and he gave okay, so sorry for that. As Louis Pasteur, now Louis Pasteur, one thing to remember that he is father of the microbiology plus fermentation principle diya tha, and he gave the S for sterilization technique, T for he gave the germ theory of disease, and rejected the theory of spontaneous generation. Pasteurization of milk is remembered, or R for he gave the vaccination for rabies, anthrax and cholera. Now he also gave the liquid media concept. Now Joseph Lister is can be remembered by, he was a father of antiseptic surgery. Now coming to Robert Koch he introduced the solid media and iske alawa Koch postulate diya tha he observed the guinea pig already infected with the tubercular bacilli developed a hypersensitive reaction when they injected with the tubercular bacilli or its protein and Koch for this is Koch phenomena and the Koch postulate is that microorganism that may can be accepted the causative agents only when it fulfills the four criteria एक तो ये कि जब द सेम ऑर्गेनिज्म कॉन्स्टेंटली एसोसिएटेड विद द डिजीज लीजन एंड इट इज़ पॉसिबल टू आइसोलेट द ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम द होस्ट एंड टू री इनोकुलेट इन द लेबोरेटरी एनिमल एंड इट विल कॉज द सेम फॉर द डिजीज इन द न्यू होस्ट एंड इट इज़ अगेन पॉसिबल टू री आइसोलेट द ऑर्गेनिज्म फ्रॉम द एक्सपेरिमेंटल एनिमल दैट वी यूज सो दीज आर द फोर criteria for the cause postulate but what are the exception three exception that is mycobacterium laprae one is trypanoma palidium and another is a neisseria gonorrhea because mycobacterium laprae and trypanoma palidium they cannot be grown in vitro but they can be maintained in the experimental animals but neisseria gonorrhea is not possible to there is no animal mode but it is possible to grow in the medium to grow in vitro. Now Paul Ehrlich is the father of the chemotherapy and he gave the side chain theory of the for antibody production. Okay, coming to the summary. क्लैप्सिला वॉट इज द मेन पॉइंट्स ऑफ द क्लैप्सिला कि एक तो कैटलेज पॉजिटिव होता है यूरियस पॉजिटिव होता है प्लस इट्स गिव द डॉम शेप्ड कॉलोनीज इन द मेकॉन्किया गार्ड ड्यू टू प्रेजेंस ऑफ द थिक कैप्सूल्स एंड दैट गिव्स द स्टिकी पिंक कॉलोनी ऑफ द मेकॉन्की अगार एंड द स्लाइमी अपीयरेंस ऑन द ब्लड अगार एंड इट ऑल्सो गिव्स द स्ट्रिंग टेस्ट एंड द स्ट्रिंग टेस्ट इज गिवन बाय द विब्रो कॉलरी और एक दिया जाता है क्लैप्सिला एंड द विब्रो नाउ इट इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर कि जो क्लैप्सिला न्यूमोनेट कॉजेज द अपर लोब डिजीज क्योंकि इट द ऑक्सीजन कंसनट्रेशन फेवर्स द ग्रोथ ऑफ द क्लैप्सिला नाउ इट ऑल्सो द कॉज फॉर the UTI and is a common commensal for the vaginal flora and it also causes the hospital acquired nosocomial infections now Klebsiella oestrogena kya hota it causes the atrophic rhinitis ya fir foul smelling discharge jabki Klebsiella rhinoscleromatis they causes rhinoscleroma or the woody nose jisme biopsy pe two important pathological features ki ek to mucolytic cells present hote hain dusra russell bodies now mucolytic cells kya hote hain they are large form cells vacuolated cytoplasm with central nucleus and presence of the Klebsiella bacilli ऑल्सो वन मोर थिंग कि रूसेल बॉडीज़ क्या होते हैं कि ईओसिनोफिलिक इंक्लूजन बॉडीज होते हैं दैट इज फाउंड इन द प्लाज्मा सेल्स दे अकर ड्यू टू अक्यूमुलेशन ऑफ द हीमोग्लोबिन सीक्रेटेड बाय द प्लाज्मा सेल्स नाउ यू कैन सी इन द मैग्नीफाइड पिक्चर कि ये तो है म्यूकुलिक सेल्स वेक्यूलेटेड सेल्स विद सेंट्रल साइटोप्लाज्म एंड दिस इज द दीज आर द रूसेल बॉडीज Now Klebsiella pneumonia red currant jelly produce करता है and one more thing to remember Serratia the Serratia bacteria produces the pigment that is protogeosin and the protogeosin is non diffusible pigment जबकि diffusible pigment is produced by the Staphylococcus aureus and the pseudomonas now protease important test to remember that PCP gives PPA test and it is motile and non-fermenters non-lactose fermenters can be removed by the mnemonic shifts and one more thing ki PCP PPA test positive PCP pleomorphism is also present and it shows the very characteristic swarming appearance sirf protease nahi clostridium tetani विब्रो पैरा हिमोलिटिकस एंड सिरेशिया इज ऑल्सो शोज एंड वन मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट फीचर की डाइन्स फिनोमिना इज शोन डाइन्स फिनोमिना इज यूज टू डिफ्रेंशिएट बिटवीन द डिफरेंट स्ट्रेन्स ऑफ द प्रोटीज एंड इट प्रोड्यूस पीस प्रोटीज फ्रॉम द फॉस्फेट स्टोन्स सो बेसिकली पी से पी पी ए टेस्ट पॉजिटिव है पी से प्लियोमॉर्फिज्म है और पी से फॉस्फेट स्टोन्स प्रेजेंट है नाउ कल्चर स्वार्मिंग पैटर्न शो करेगा किसमें, ब्लड अगार में. नाउ दिस इज पीपी टेस्ट शोइंग द चेंज देर इज ग्रीन कलर एंड इफ नो फिनाइलएलनिड डीएमिनेज इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द ऑर्गेनिज्म देन नो कलर विल बी शोन. नाउ दिस इज डाइन्स फिनोमिना, दिस इज नैरो जोन ऑफ हीमोलिसिस शोन बाय द टू डिफरेंट नैरो जोन ऑफ डिफरेंट दिस नैरो विजिबल फेरो शोन बाय द डिफरेंट स्ट्रेन ऑफ प्रोटीज शोइंग कि दीज आर टू डिफरेंट स्ट्रेन. इफ दे हैव कम्प्लीटली मर्ज देन इट वुड हैव बीन शोन बाय द सेम स्ट्रेन. दिस अगेंस्ट द टाइम्स फिनोमिना वेन टू इन टू स्ट्रेन सर्कुलेटेड इन द सेम मीडिया वैन दे आर कम्प्लीटली मर्ज दे विल बी आइडेंटिकल स्ट्रेन इफ नॉट एंड दे विल बी डिफरेंट टू डिफरेंट स्ट्रेन. नाउ स्ट्रीविट स्टोन्स टू वाइट स्टोन is produced by the protease and also clepsylla and stovetones are the staghorn stones taking the shape of the renal pelvic shape. Now it is caused by the urease producing or bacteria. Urease producing kya karega, urea ko ammonia mein tod dega and ammonia will increase the alkalinity of the urine causing the deposition of the phosphate. Okay, now thank you for today's session and please do use my code that is Muskan to get additional 10% discount on the subscription and have a good day.